Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this video, I'm going to set up a very simple demonstration that's going to show you how erasure code functions with a very small erasure set. Now, this demo is 100% not for production. I am doing this entire demo in a Docker container. I am using directories on a single drive to emulate four drives in my Docker container, which means that this is not safe in any way for production. So in our lab environment, you can see here, I have a little MinIO Erasure piece of code. Let me show you the Docker container that we're gonna set up for this. So I have a Docker Compose. Let me go ahead and show you what's in that Docker Compose. There we go. And it's a very simple Docker Compose file. There's not much to this other than how I'm setting up my erasure set. Okay, so I have four volumes. Now, these are just directories on my system. Again, do not do this in production, but I have four volumes and notice they are sequentially named. 1, 2, 3, 4, data 1, data 2, data 3, data 4. In an erasure set, you're going to want to have these sequentially named drives. Additionally, if we're doing an erasure set across multiple servers, which is also highly recommended, particularly for production, you are going to set up your servers to be sequentially numbered as well. And the reason for this is the command line that you see there that says server console address. The last part of that is going to show me the collection of servers and drives that I'm going to put in this server pool. Now, for this server pool, it's one server, so I don't have to give it any server information. I am just giving it the drive locations, data 1, 2, 3, 4. And notice I'm using that expansion notation with the curly braces, 1.4. Similarly, if I was doing this across multiple servers, I would have the server names. I'd have an HTTPS, :// MinIO, curly braces, 1 through 4, or whatever, with my domain name. And that would build a single server pool with my erasure set on it. Now, this erasure set is going to have a size of 4. With a size of 4, it's going to set the parity at 2 by default. I don't want a 2 for my parity because that's going to use half of my drives for parity and half of my drives for data. What I want to do is I want to set my parity at 1. So I'll have 3 data parts every time I upload an object and 1 parity part every time I upload an object for a total of 4. What this means is that I can lose one drive and no more than one drive and my data will still be safe. So let's go ahead and fire this up. I'm going to do a Docker compose up. And I'm going to throw a little ampersand there on the end so that it's running in the background. So we're going to be able to see any console messages coming down to my terminal window here. Let me go ahead and run this. So this brings this up and it formats my first pool, 1 set, 4 drives per set. Important warning, this local host has more than 1 drives of the set. That means that a host failure, if I lose the entire server, it's going to mean the data becomes unavailable. Okay, so very important. If I wanted to do an erasure set in production, I would want to have at least 2 servers. Okay, at least 2 servers. That way, if I lose a server, I'm not going to lose all of my data. So this has formatted the erasure set for me. Let me go ahead and clear this. I can check that by doing an MC admin info minio1. And with that MC admin minio1, I can see there, right there in my pool. My first pool has an erasure set, 1 erasure set. There are 4 drives in that erasure set. 4 drives are online, 0 drives are offline. Everything is good. Everything is happy. Okay, so with that, let's go ahead and create a bucket. MC MB minio1 erasure is going to be my bucket name. This creates a bucket. Now, even the bucket is going to be split across all of the drives in my erasure set. This is so the data can be shared across all of the drives in my erasure set. Let me show you this. I'm going to do a tree on MinIO data. And there are my buckets. Erasure, 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 erasure across MinIO 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, this is exactly why I am doing this demo in Docker, sharing this drive so that I can do things like this tree and show you what's going on here. Again, do not do something like this in production. Have separate physical drives on separate physical servers, or if you're going in the cloud, obviously just separate drives, separate servers, okay? So there are our erasure bucket spanning the four drives in my erasure set. Let's go ahead and upload a file, mccp. And we're going to take that sample text and we're going to upload that now to our erasure bucket. And up it goes. Now what's going to happen here is this object is going to span three of the drives and the fourth drive is going to have a parity part. Let me show you this. I'm going to run that tree command again. So now when I run this tree command again, we see that my sample text object is spanning all of the drives. Three of those are data parts, and one of them is a parity part. Let's take a look at this. Since I'm doing text, what you're going to see is this is actually going to split it up. You're actually going to see different parts of that sample text in different pieces, and then our parity part is going to be very, very different. So let me go ahead and clear this again, and we will do a more on MinIO1. This is the first part in our first data drive. There we go. Well, it's part of the text. So this text is actually from a very famous painter and also a great educator. So notice it starts off with, we'll have a super time and so on and so forth. There's some meta information there as well, but that is one part. If I do another part, let me go through all of these. Here is the next part. Notice it's a different part of the text, right? And in this case, it's got the ending piece there. It's our Bob Ross lorem ipsum. And then if I do the third part, let's see what we have for our third part. Ah, our third part is our parity part. This is not text anymore. This is the parity part that we can use to reconstruct the object if it gets destroyed. And of course, if I take a look at the fourth part, we're back to the text again. As you can see, it has split up the object, and since we're using a text object, it's easy to see that it's splitting pieces here and there. We don't have the same text in every single object part. And then we also have that parity part. If I do a stat on MinIO1, erasure, sample text, it's fine. It tells me that it's got a size there, it's got an E tag. So the next thing we're going to do is we are going to simulate losing a drive. And the way I'm going to simulate losing a drive is while my Docker container is running, I'm going to delete a directory. So I'm going to do a sudo rm-rf, and we're going to take down just one. We don't need all of them to go. MinIO data, MinIO. Let's take one of the actual parts. Let's take MinIO 2. We'll take that drive offline. So when we run that, that drive is now gone. What happens if I do a stat on the server? MC admin. Before I could even finish typing it, now we're getting this error. Error, file access denied. Endpoint data 2 is gone. I've lost my drive. So let me go ahead and clear this one more time. And if I do an MC admin info MinIO1, what do we see? Well, I've got, it says four drives are online. I have one bucket, one object. The thing is I can't write to that one drive that I've taken offline. So the drive is actually gone. Let me show you this. If I do an MC stat on the same sample text again, notice that it still says everything's fine, even though I have dropped one of the actual parts. This is because I have the other part there. Let me show you this. If I do an MC admin heal MinIO1 erasure, I'm going to check this bucket. Have a little problem here, don't I? I have two parts still. One part is missing. It's gone. It's red. So that's a bit of a problem. And those other two parts, they're saying, yeah, I can still work with this because my erasure set's still functional. But if I lose another part, I'm gone. There's nothing I can do here. So I am missing a part. I have one part red on this object. Now, again, if I go back, let me do the MC stat again. The MC stat says it's fine. It works. It's there. And that's because I can reconstruct this object on the fly. Now, what if I wanted to heal all of this? I wanted to fix it so it went back together. Well, let's imagine we're replacing the drive because that's how we're going to do this. So I'm going to do a clear. And to replace a drive, you would, generally speaking, bring the server down. You could hot swap, but in this case, I'm going to just bring the server down. Docker compose down. And when I do a Docker compose down, that brings down my service. And then I'm going to do the Docker compose up again. And when we do the Docker compose up, check this out. It comes back online and it says, okay, we've got three online, one offline. So I'm still missing something. But what happened is Docker recreates that directory. And when it recreated the directory, it said, oh, wait, here's that drive again. So we're healing the drive. Data 2 is being healed in this case, as you can see there right at the bottom. And it's doing that process very, very quickly. It healed the drive very, very quickly for us. It's all complete. Okay. Obviously, in a situation where I had many more objects or a lot more data, the healing would take longer. Okay. But in this case, I could track that if I wanted to check the current status. I could do an MC admin heal alias verbose if I wanted to check the status on that. Obviously, it's done, so there's nothing to check there. But let us do a clear. And I'm going to do an MC admin heal on MinIO 1 erasure a second time, and you will see. Ah, now we're good. Our parts are there. All three parts are back where we need them to be. And we still have the parity part. If I do the tree command one more time, the parity part is still there. Remember, we saw that on data 3. That's the MinIO 3 part. So we have our parity part. Our parity part allowed the object to remain accessible, remain available for me. But at the same time, the MC admin heal told me that there was a problem. And of course, if I was looking in my console, I would see that there was a problem. I could trigger a healing from the console and things of that nature. So that is everything that I wanted to show you on the erasure set. Again, this environment is entirely just for a demo. I would never run something this fragile in production, where if I lose anything, I'm going to lose everything. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. I hope you have enjoyed this little demonstration. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can contact us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.